as a mother now, what is your simple message to some of these who one way or the other?
As a mother, my take home message by perhaps being a little less militant than as a crusader. These agitations are entirely justified. You cannot box a people, you cannot deprive generations of young people of the future, of inclusion in a country that they are supposed to call their own, but they are totally out in the world by way of federal appointments, by way of employment in terms of industries, factories, even in the education quota, they are not required. Ugbo-land has almost become a synonym for a wasted generation of youth who are not given an opportunity by the Nigerian state to excel. Yet, when they leave the shores of this country, you hear about their great exploits. You keep hearing, first mayor here in Ugbo-land, first engineer, they excel because their potential is subdued and suppressed to ensure that this region remains a wasteland. It is only given that their anger will get to a crescendo and they have to vent their anger. So the justification for the agitation is there. For as long as there is injustice, for as long as there is oppression, for as long as there is inequality, for as long as there is inequity in the distribution of the nation's resources, in opportunities for young people, for as long as young people in Ugbo-land are facing a future without hope, Biafra lives. Biafra will never die, because that is the only hope of the opportunity of a decent future for these young people. So when they agitate, they are not agitating purely because they are at home and they are feeling bored. They are not agitating because they want to be out on the streets and they want to be shot dead. They are not agitating because they are asking for money. They are just asking for equal opportunities and the opportunity to be treated as equal citizens in a country that they are supposed to call their own.
Okay, coming back home, do you think Igbo leaders have done well for their
people? No, they have not. They have not done well for their people because their politics has been essentially politics of their own interests. Whenever they have an opportunity to negotiate for their people, they go there, negotiate a soft landing for themselves. They are in a rat race to be included in the center. And in doing so, they jeopardize their willing to subjugate the welfare, the interests of their own people. And for that reason, I say that they are exiles because they keep coming back to Ugbo-land as if they are expats. If they live here, if they see the difficulty that regular people face on a day-to-day basis, if they can even perceive the sense of helplessness, of hopelessness in the general environment in Ugbo-land, they will understand. But because they are excluded from that, because they are cocooned and cushioned from all that, because they live elsewhere and only come into Ugbo-land, they will really never fully understand what people in this country are doing.
When you said that the federal government should give this because of the people, what can you come to
Well, there's nothing that can be clearer than the point I made earlier, that those who are denied justice have no interest in peace. If you keep pushing a people to the wall, the only kind of expectation that there will be is that people will say, what's the point of life? I'm living in a country where I am supposed to be a citizen, and yet I am hunted. And yet I am not given equal citizenship rights. Young people of today do not have the experience of the war. They don't know what their parents went through. They don't know that everything you see in Igbo land today is like the phoenix rising from the ashes of 20 pounds. Their parents went through hell. They didn't see that. And because they haven't seen that, the idea of war to achieve their aims is romantic. It's a romantic idea, but people who are older know that war is hell. And if the Nigerian government refuses to review its strategy, to review its stance on the Southeast, we're sitting, we're a nation sitting very precariously on the cake.
Thank you very much.